This Mr. Claude?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
Hey, Mr. Claude, this is Chris Scott. I know this is a little random, sir. I apologize, but I want to write you a very, very large check today, sir. And when I say very large, I mean very large.
What's this? Okay. You got my curiosity, but this sounds scammy, man.
You know what, sir? And I can respect that, sir. I appreciate that. This is not a scam, sir. My name is Chris Scott. I'm a commercial property investor. I've been doing this for over 10 years, sir. I'm very serious. I have the cash or the credit to move really quickly, sir. Would you wouldn't be interested in getting a very large check for your property over there on, in Lancaster, would you?
Well, you know, it's funny you said that. I'm thinking of retiring next year. And my kids don't want to manage this building, but I'm not ready to sell it right now.
Yeah. Retirement, that's a beautiful thing. Congratulations. And I appreciate you sharing that with me. I'm just surprised. Well, I mean, why wouldn't your kids want to manage something like that, sir?
My son has his own career. He's a supermarket manager. My daughter is an actress in Los Angeles, and they have their own lives. They don't love real estate as much as I do. I've been in real estate 32 years.
Wow, that's a very long time, sir. Is it okay? Can I just ask you a quick question or two, just to kind of figure out which way we could possibly do business in the future, sir?
I could. Let's take a quick timeout.
Sure.
Two things. One of my students, Alex, I believe, he uses a great line, which I stole from him. When he calls somebody up, and I assume this building is near where you live in Dallas.
Yes. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
He uses a word called, he uses an expression. He says, I'm your neighbor. I love that. Evokes warmth and nearby. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And everything. You might have slipped that in there. I'm one of your neighbors. I've seen your building before. Maybe you saw it on Zillow or drove past it. I don't know. Mm-hmm. The other thing, you might have stroked me a little bit more. Number one persuasion technique from Robert Cialdini's book, mm-hmm. Is stroking and nurturing, or I added nurturing. Nurturing is when to make it very emotional. When I said that I've been in the real estate for 32 years and everything, and I got good kids, you got to say, well, sounds like you're a good parent. You raised two kids, they're independent and everything. And I could learn so much from you being in real estate. You know, we call it schmoozing. What do you call it? Blowing smoke. If you do it, if you're a good enough actor and you do it well enough, and maybe you mean it sincerely, I do, because I love learning from other people. That is such a super stroke. Mm-hmm. To get this guy to like you, because you're showing an older guy respect.
Yeah, I love that.
And he will love you. How much easier is it to do business with someone who likes you?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. No, so let's go ahead.
No, I'm sorry, I interrupted you.
No, I was just saying that's the best prospect. When they get likability, it becomes an easier dance.
And much easier. And then you go into your question. Hey, can I ask you too? You do the agenda step, which is the first step in the gut success staircase. And tell people what the agenda step is just before you do it.
Sure. Yeah. Now the agenda is a very important part of the conversation. The agenda is the first step in the guts negotiation, where we basically draw out our roadmap and we tell the prospect, this is how the conversation is about to go. And then we also ask permission to ask questions. We draw a roadmap. And then lastly, we let the prospect know at the end of the conversation, it's okay to say no to me, or you don't have to tell me you'll think about it. We don't want to hear you'll think about it at the end. We just want a cut and dry answer. And agenda helps us set that up.
You summarized that beautifully. I even nurture during the agenda. Hey, Mr. Scott, could you do me just a small personal favor? At the end of this conversation, would you do me a favor? Would you fire me?
Yeah.
Would you tell me to get lost? I'd love to do business with you, sir. I'm very interested in your building. I want to make you an offer, even if it's for next year, sir. But if we can't do business, would you just tell me to get lost? You don't have to say your thing. You don't have to be polite to me. I can take it. You know, beautiful. I got some boohoo tissues here. Okay. Right. Actually, I do. I always keep my boo. Even in North Carolina, I have my boohoo tissues. Tell everybody when do I use my boohoo tissues?
When you start to get excuses from salesmen who make all these excuses about their prospects. Yeah.
When people give me excuses, I see, because I think the foundation of guts is not only honesty and transparency, but taking responsibility for yourself and your act. You know, when you take responsibility for your life, it just eliminates all the garbage.
Absolutely.
You know, you can blame God, you can blame the weather. It's easy to blame lawyers and politicians. You can blame Putin, you can blame anybody. But when you go to the bathroom mirror and say, hey man, I got to pick up that phone today. I'm going to call people. A lot of people are going to say no, but maybe someone will say yes. And I will persevere. And if it's going to be, it's up to me.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. I'm sorry we digress. Let's go back in your wonderful role play here. Give me that stroke though. Super stroke. I've been in real estate about 32 years here. And my kids are, they got their own lives, their own careers. I'm going to end up selling it probably next year.
That's fantastic, sir. You know, and I appreciate you sharing that with me, sir. You sound like you're a great father and you've done really well with your children.
I try. Thank you.
Well, you raised two independent children and you've been in real estate for 32 years. I know there's a lot that I can learn from someone like you.
I'm getting a Woody here. This is so good, man. This is so good. It's when you say the right words, the right way at the right time. Mm-hmm. Man, you got me in this conversation now. I'm going to treat you like you're from part of my family, a next door neighbor, a friend I'm familiar with. You've transcended from a cold call to making me interested and liking you. Why? Because you're doing this, baby, and I love it. Yes. And you're doing it so well. You're being creative. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So well. Sorry to interrupt again, but I love the way you did that, man.
Definitely, definitely. No, interrupt. I want any analysis. So, all right. Sir, is it okay if I just ask you a quick question or two just to kind of figure out, which way we could do business maybe?
I got to take my wife shopping. Can we get done in about 15 minutes or less?
Sir, you give me 15 minutes. And at the end of the day, would you do me a very small favor, sir? Will you do me just a small favor at the end of this conversation? If you don't what I propose or the deal or me even, would you do me a small favor and just fire me? You don't have to tell me or think about
it. You sound like a nice young man. Why would I want to fire you?
Well, if we can't come to, you don't have to tell me you'll think about it or, light a candle in church or anything. Like, you could just say, Chris, you're fired.
I love when you take my line, so light a candle in church. I don't know where I got that from.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
I love that one. I love that one. And pray to a pet rock. Right.
I don't think anyone knows what a pet rock is anymore, man. Mm-hmm. that'd be great. As long as you can get me out of here in 15 minutes, I don't want to, happy marriage, man. Happy wife, don't keep her waiting.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Well, let me ask you this, sir. Can I tell you the truth or you want me to blow hot air up you know what?
No, get right to it. Just straight up, man.
Well, I'm your neighbor, sir. I ride by the property regularly and I see the property is being run down. You could be making a lot more money on that property than what your current income is. Why haven't you done anything to...
Okay, I'm going to do a timeout here.
All right, go ahead.
I've been in real estate 32 years. Maybe I own this building for 10, 15 years. This is my baby. And now you just called me a slumlord.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Be